You know, people say that in today's education world, at least 75% of these students are not employable. In this sense, for every 100 students admitted to college education, 75% will not come out with employable skill at the end of their graduation program. Now, whom do we blame this? Do we blame this to the university, or to the college, to the faculty, or to the students themselves? Now, as students, what you can do? See, there is a limitation as to how much a student can change a teacher or a college or a university. Rather, as a student, can you change yourself to get yourself employed? And at the end of 3 years or 4 years, he completes his graduation. Now, being a graduate, what are the things he can do it on his own by using his technical skills, which is capable of being marketed in economic terms? For example, a computer science graduate is expected to do certain basic activities which can be economically viable. For example, can a graduate in computer science design a website on his own? And can he market it successfully? Can he give it to someone for a price? And if he is still smart, can he convert this website into a web portal? Does he understand the difference between a website and web portal? Or for that matter, a BSc student or BSc in computer science, does he know how to use CorelDRAW or Photoshop? See, theoretically he may have learned, but using Photoshop, can he edit a photo or use knowledge and skill? Is it confusing the student as to what is a knowledge and what is a skill and how knowledge differs from skill? See right here, people playing cricket. Okay, in the interviews we ask students or the candidates about what are their hobbies. They say cricket. Now, how do we infer cricket means whether he is a cricketer or not? When we inquire about whether he plays cricket, then the candidate says, no, I watch cricket. Now, what is the difference between someone watching cricket and someone playing cricket? Both has knowledge about cricket. Both know very well about what the rules of the game as regards cricket. But the difference is someone who is only good at watching cricket and understanding it, he can gain knowledge. Whereas someone who comes to the playground, plays cricket, that is called skill. A third or fourth thing that you have to do is you have to have a good self-concept. Self-concept essentially about the beliefs and practices that you have about yourself. If you have positive beliefs and practices about yourself, that will take you to greater height. And the fourth thing is the motive. What kind of motives that you have? When we interview candidates, everyone says, I want to work for this organization, I am a good person. But it turns out at a later point that 1 or 2% of every 100 candidates we hire will have ulterior motives. They end up committing crimes, they end up committing frauds, and they end up losing job. Now, I believe I have explained to you about knowledge, skill, self-concept and motives that will take you to greater heights. So learn well, practice it in the ground, if it is cricket, or practice it on the job, that will give you skill. Then refine and retune your self-concept, the beliefs and practices that you have about yourself. Be a positive-minded person and then have clear motives. Your needs, your aspirations, your motives should be clear to grow yourself without harming others, without violating law.